At some point, we are all going to age. Today, the population in the United States and the world is older than ever before. By 2020, for the first time in history, there'll be more people over age 65 than under 5. With a foresight to address this trend, Congress established the National Institute on Aging in 1974. It is now one of the 27 institutes and centers that make up the National Institutes of Health, the nation's primary federal agency for research to prevent, detect, diagnose, and treat disease and disability. Since its founding, the NIA has been committed to discovering the secrets to a healthy old age, as well as understanding and addressing disease and disability that can occur as we grow older. In the U.S., healthy aging is now a particular challenge. While trends in life expectancy have improved over time, not all older adults are aging in good health. That is why here at NIA, we support and conduct cutting-edge research to extend the healthy and active years of life. Some of this research is conducted by scientists and fellows in our own laboratories in Bethesda and Baltimore, Maryland. The vast majority of NIA-supported research is led by scientists at universities, hospitals, medical centers, and private organizations all around the country. Reflecting the enormous effect of aging on all aspects of our lives, NIA's portfolio of research is comprehensive and varied. Our research ranges from the study of basic cellular changes that come with age to the examination of the biomedical, social, and behavioral aspects of growing older. This work has led to important scientific discoveries about healthy aging, including regular, balanced, and moderate physical activity significantly reduces risk of major mobility disability. Controlling blood pressure can reduce heart attacks, stroke, and death in people age 50 and older. Weight loss through dietary changes and increased physical activity and treatment with a diabetes medication can prevent or delay the onset of type 2 diabetes. Interventions involving types of food and diets, drugs and hormones can lead to longer lifespan and health span in mice. Some of these approaches are now being tested in people too. NIA leads the federal effort to study Alzheimer's disease and related dementias. Intensified research in this area has led to critical insights, bringing us closer to finding effective ways to treat or prevent these devastating disorders. We have found that training on specific reasoning and speed of processing tasks, two key indicators of cognition, can improve performance on those tasks under controlled conditions. Benefits on reasoning were shown to last at least 5 years, while benefits on speed of processing persisted for up to 10 years. We can now see brain changes that occur years, even decades, before symptoms of Alzheimer's disease and related dementias first appear. We have discovered more than 25 genes involved in Alzheimer's disease, allowing studies into how they may contribute to the disease. We have identified the first effective support intervention to improve the health and well-being of Alzheimer's caregivers in an ethnically diverse population. NIA also has an important role in educating and training the next generation of scientists in aging and dementia research. Initiatives like the Butler Williams Scholars Program, fellowships and career development awards, and grant awards for new and early stage investigators are some of the ways we support these efforts. NIA works hard to make sure that what we learn from this research is widely shared with the public, with patients and families, healthcare providers, and advocates and policymakers. Free health information is available on age-related diseases, healthy eating, exercise and physical activity, cognitive health, doctor-patient communication, end of life, caregiving, and participating in clinical studies. Check out our website at www.nia.nih.gov. You can get health information, read our blog for scientists, and learn about research funding opportunities. You can also find out about joining us as partners in research. Together, we will continue the search for the most effective ways to help us all live a life free of disease and disability for as long as we can.